At the age of 10, she met an accident in which she lost her father and her face was fully devastated. Life hits her hard, but despite all these hardships, she managed her debut book.
I have struggled a lot in my life to become a good writer, though I'm not a good writer, but I have made an effort towards writing. When I was a kid, right from that day, I used to write like that diary noting. And that diary noting was actually a person noting for myself. That included what I did during the whole day, or about the school life, or about everything. I have written a book. The book is Finding the Lost You. The book deals with inspiration and motivation. One has to be an inspiration for himself or herself, because koi aur nahi aa sakta aapko inspiration dene, until and unless you don't have your own self-will, or you're not ready to work for yourself, nothing is possible in this world. The book is same. It's like an open counseling box. During just coming back from the travel, we met with an accident. I was with my father, and in that accident he just lost his life and I just survived. So the survival was not so easy, because I had just my face was completely devastated, and after that I became a victim of depression, anxiety and stress, and it continued for about 7 years. It requires a lot of time and a lot of struggle too. My struggle is quite difficult in terms of myself, though it was not in terms of money or something else, but it was in terms of my own determination. I was lacking my own determination. I was lacking my own power. I was I was deeply disturbed. My future plans are, I'm just working on the second project, and inshallah that will come soon on the surface, and that will be also a turning point of our society. My favorite author is Arundhati Roy. She's my hero, because her writings are completely different. I admire her a lot. Like, my mom is my inspiration. It's all because of her I'm standing here. I'm delivering something to someone. I have just written a book, and I'm just happy for myself, because I have done something for myself and for mom. And now it's because of this, or whatever is happening because of all this, my mom is reflecting a smile, and I'm very happy about this. This is the most asked question, because everyone asks me that you should just go with the literature, or you should have went with the literature. But I don't feel, even some experts said to me, and that is the thing that I will just keep on going. They said to me, to be a literature, to be an author, you need not to be a literature student. You just need to have a broader vision. I want to just say that there is a lot of criticism in our society. Everybody criticizes. Even when I wrote this book, nobody encouraged me in the initial. Even I just put it on my social site, that which Instagram. I even updated the status that some questions that were being asked to me, like by some strangers, even if I didn't know them, they said to me that you're living somewhere where you need to reflect that part. But is it necessary, is it possible that when you're just unaware about your own self, how can you just think about the society? So our society criticizes it, mocks a lot, but there are some people who are presently, with whom I have just recently got in contact, they encourage a lot, and that encouragement is quite needed, because that is the only thing that will just pave a good way for our future, goals, or that is the only way to let the flowers to bloom. I have come across a book, My Secret, which also deals with the inspiration. That's not inspiration, that deals with your inner power. So that book actually boosted me to write, yes, if there is inner power, then obviously motivation and inspiration lies within you. If you are depressed, or if you have lost your will, don't be like sad, or don't lock up yourself in a room, because that won't help you out. You have to move out of the room. You have to see what the atmosphere is about. You have to feel the air. You don't have to only survive. You have to live your life.
Bijbehara in Anantnag, or Kashmiri unheard.